2020 has become a very strange year in the recent history. For the first time, we have got some delay in the Earth's overshoot day due to something we could have liked to miss. We don't like the reasons why this has come this way, but we understand that the planet has got an additional time to breathe. Now we know that it is important to take decisions based on science, to take into consideration the emergency, the urgency to react to something which is probably the worst threat on humankind for decades, for centuries, for years, but also a great threat for the whole balance of the planet and the climate system of the Earth. And I think that this is something that has already been understood by the different social and economic players. Now we need to do things in a different manner. Now we need to understand that solutions based on science, consistent with science and knowledge, solutions for human prosperity, but also consistent with the planetary limits, are very important if we want to achieve a sustainable, long-lasting prosperity in our planet. This means to react in a different manner. This means to understand that the green recovery coming out from this health crisis is quite an important issue in the policy agenda, in the politics, but also in the public opinion agenda. And we need to create the framework to allow people to take the right decisions in the time to be. We need to use all the resources and stimulus package that we can put in place in order to facilitate the deep transformation we knew we had to take on board. And this is what we are trying to do here in Spain, as in many other countries, to think about our urban agenda, the mobility of the people and the mercantile and the trading and the merchandising, but also to think about the innovation, the industry, the way we produce and consume energy and other goods. And I guess that there are many things we can do. We can put in place the regulatory framework through new legislation. We can think in the mid and long term, so to plan, to identify, to find out what are the main challenges we need to overcome and we need to take into consideration to create opportunities out of this situation. We need to think in the goals, in the targets we fix in our agenda for 2030, but also for 2050, where we should be absolutely out of the carbon economy. We should be absolutely decarbonized. We could need to be inspired by biodiversity ecosystems and the way nature works, so that we can identify what type of green investments, what type of green infrastructure, what type of ecosystem solutions we can put in place in order to facilitate our ecosystems to be much more adaptive and resilient to climate impacts. And I think that this is something we can make. People is demanding for that. The accent being put on what about the next generation is absolutely key. We have been over 50 degrees in Baghdad. We have witnessed terrible wildfires in Siberia. We are witnessing great heat waves all around the world, or the melting of the poles in a very short period of time, and the disparition of species in the wildlife. So I think that these are signals that we cannot keep on going as we used to do. At the same time, we have been an implosion. We have witnessed a great implosion of the price of oil, of the price of gas, deep value changes in our mindset, so to think in mobility in different terms, and we have learned that we can do things differently, but we need to do things differently for a different reason from the current one, just because we know that it is in our interest to invest in a different manner for a different future.